Hello friends, welcome to this video on number systems. Friends, basically we are familiar with four operations, namely addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. These operations help us to establish relationships between numbers. Today, we will discuss operations on real numbers and some identities. Friends, we have learned that rational numbers satisfy the commutative, associative, and distributive properties for addition and multiplication. Friends, if we add, subtract, or multiply any two or more rational numbers, then the resultant number is also a rational number. Can we say the same for division also? Let us see. Here are two rational numbers. When we divide them, we will still get a rational number. Please notice here, in place of 2 by 3, if we keep 0 and then divide it by 3 by 2, we will get 0, which is a rational number. But now, if we replace 3 by 2 by 0 and divide 2 by 3 by 0, we will get a number which is undefined, or say that it isn't a rational number. Therefore, we can say that rational numbers are not closed under division. But if we consider a set of non-zero rational numbers, then that set will be closed under division. Irrational numbers also follow the commutative, associative, and distributive rules of addition and multiplication. But on adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing irrational numbers, the number so obtained is not always an irrational number. That means irrational numbers are not closed under these operations. Friends, you can easily understand the same by looking at these examples. Here, we are getting both rational and irrational numbers. Friends, all these facts are true for operations between same type of numbers. Now let's learn these operations between rational and irrational numbers. 4 is the rational number, and root 19 is an irrational number. Can you tell on adding the two, will we be getting a rational number or an irrational number? The decimal form of root 19 is non-terminating, non-recurring. Therefore, the decimal form of 4 plus root 19 will also be non-terminating, non-recurring. That means this is an irrational number. Friends, let's try it for subtraction. Root 6 minus 3 will be irrational number, since root 6 is an irrational number. On multiplying 2 with root 5, we will get 2 root 5, which is also an irrational number. Now let's do the same for division. Root 17 is an irrational number. Its decimal form is non-terminating, non-recurring. On dividing the same by 4, we will get root 17 by 4, whose decimal form will also be non-terminating, non-recurring. That means it is an irrational number. After seeing all these examples, we can conclude that the number so obtained on adding and subtracting a rational number with an irrational number will be an irrational number. Similarly, the number obtained by multiplying and dividing an irrational number with a non-zero rational number will also be an irrational number. Let's move ahead. Consider, if A and B are positive real numbers, then root AB will be equal to root A multiplied by root B. Similarly, root A by B will be equal to root A by root B. Friends, you're familiar with these two identities. Here, A and B are real numbers. Now if we replace A by root A and B by root B in the first identity, we will get this. And here, if we keep A as it is and replace B by root B, we will get this. Now, if we do the same process with the second identity, we will get root A square plus 2 root A, root B, plus root b square. And here, root a multiplied by root b will become root ab. And now, we will finally get a plus 2 root ab plus b. Now, suppose if the numbers are this way, root a plus root b, root c plus root d, then what will we do? Let us also simplify this and see what we get. Here we will simplify just like how we open the bracket for any multiplication operation and then add the terms. Or say we will use the distributive law of multiplication over addition. Now we will get root AC plus root AD plus root BC plus root BD. All these identities related to square root are useful in different ways. In the next video, we will discuss them in detail. That's all in this session. In this video, we discussed operations on real numbers and some identities. Thank you.